have to say, the biggest reason I did the entire Aida and Tulip of modern Syrian folk art dolls was because of my research for my book, Restoring Damascus with Watered Down Paint, when I really found out how much women participated in the architectural and shape of what Damascus looks like. Never mind embroidery, needlework, sewing, poetry, literature. It's the these beautiful pink buildings, the way the colors just have stayed with us all these years, how the rain comes down and they just bleed over each other in these beautiful multi-layers of blush. And Tulip Kurdi, thanks to her and all her enthusiasm, really made this entire project complete and beautiful.
I have loved dolls since I was a child. During the Eid in Damascus, you know, everybody was fasting, and then we got to buy one fancy gift. I always bought a doll. And when I was on my way to America in the 70s to visit my American family, my mom's family, my father bought me this beautiful Czech doll at the free shop in Prague. And then I had another one from Russia later on from a very good friend from the Imadis. And, you know, so I had this fantastic appreciation for what dolls look like and how, you know, they can be culturally oriented, you know, which is a lot for a little kid, but it worked wonders for me. Like I said, I only think in textiles. And Lord knows I don't know any good thing about social media, but what I do understand is textiles and color and how to make a woman feel good and mythology and symbolism in women and history. And, you know, our clothes do mean something before all this mass manufacturing and Wall Street and the stock market got involved with it.